Good evening and welcome. Glad you're all here. I have a few announcements. Tomorrow is the annual Scouting Sunday, where troop members can show appreciation for their faith-based charter organization. Some of our local troop members have worn their uniforms and may be helping as greeters or readers during the services. Ask them about what they enjoy about their troop. Thank you for your support. We are in need of sponsors for Lenten soup suppers. This is a great way to earn extra funds for a special project. Please see Jenny in the church office to sign up. A special date night is being planned for Saturday, February 10th. We will babysit your kids ages 3 and up anytime between 6 p.m. and 8 p.m. in the gym while you enjoy some time together. Let Nancy Simonson know if you are planning to drop off your children. Ash Wednesday service is February 14th at 5:30 p.m.
Thank you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, President Woodford of our Minnesota South District of the Lutheran Church Missouri Synod has authorized me to install Reverend Peter Geldner as intentional interim pastor of Trinity Lutheran Church. According to the rules of good order in the church, Trinity Lutheran Church has properly called Pastor Geldner, and he has accepted that call to serve as intentional interim pastor for a period of at least 18 months. Hear the word of the Lord regarding the office of the public ministry from John 20. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, even so I am sending you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of anyone, they are forgiven. If you withhold forgiveness from anyone, it is withheld." The word of the Lord. Hear the word of the Lord regarding intentional interim ministry from Titus chapters 1 and 3. "This is why I left you in Crete, so that you might put what remained into order. Then do your best to come to me, and let our people learn to devote themselves to good works, so as to help cases of urgent need and not be unfruitful." The word of the Lord. Pastor Geldner, do you believe and confess the canonical books of the Old and New Testaments to be the inspired word of God and the only infallible rule of faith and practice?
Yes, I believe and confess the canonical scriptures to be the inspired word of God and the only infallible rule of faith and practice.
Do you believe and confess the three ecumenical creeds, namely the Apostles, the Nicene, and the Athanasian creeds, as faithful testimonies to the truth of Holy Scriptures, and do you reject all the errors which they condemn?
Yes, I believe and confess the three ecumenical creeds because they are in accord with the word of God. I also reject all the errors they condemn.
Do you confess the unaltered Augsburg Confession and all of the other Lutheran confessions as they are contained in the Book of Concord to be a true exposition of Holy Scripture and a correct exhibition of the doctrine of the Evangelical Lutheran Church?
Yes, I make these confessions my own because they are in accord with the Word of God.
Pastor Geldner, in the presence of this congregation, will you commit yourself to this new trust and responsibility and promise to discharge your duties in harmony with the Word of God and the Lutheran confessions?
I will, and I ask God to help me.
Will you love, serve, and pray for God's people? Will you nourish them with the Word and sacraments, leading them by your own example in the use of the means of grace in faithful service and holy living?
I will. And I ask God to help me.
Will you support this congregation during their interim journey? Work with the transition team. Commit yourself to neither sway the outcome of the call process nor be available for call to this congregation, and help the congregation prepare for new pastoral leadership.
I will, and I ask God to help me.
The congregation would please stand. People of God, will you receive this messenger of Jesus Christ, sent by God to serve God's people with the gospel of hope and salvation? Will you regard him as a servant of Christ and a steward of the mysteries of God? Will you pray for him, help and honor him in the work of interim ministry, and in all things strive to live together in the peace and unity of Christ? If so, answer, we will. Pastor Geldner, the office of intentional interim pastor of Trinity Lutheran Church of Faribault, Minnesota is now committed to you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal covenant, equip you with everything good that you may do his will, working in you that which is pleasing in his sight, through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen.
Since we're all standing now, the congregation, we turn now to the confession of our faith before you. Let us confess our sins to God our Father. Most merciful God, we confess that we are by nature sinful and unclean. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We justly deserve your present and eternal punishment. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. People of God, I have good news for you. Know that with joy that upon this your confession, I, by virtue of my office as a called and ordained servant of the Lord, announce the grace of God unto all of you, and in the stead and by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ, and on his behalf, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. We turn now together with the psalm. We've spoken responsibly. Praise the Lord, for it is good to sing praises to our God, for it is pleasant, and a song of praise is fitting. He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds.
He determines the number of the stars. He gives to all of them their names.
Great is our Lord and abundant in power. His understanding is beyond measure.
The Lord lifts up the humble. He casts the wicked to the ground.
Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving. Make melody to our God on the lyre. He gives to the beasts their food, and to the young ravens their cry.
His delight is not in the strength of the horse, nor his pleasure in the legs of a man.
But the Lord takes pleasure in those who fear him, in those who hope in his steadfast love. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Congregation, be seated for our first reading of the day.
Do you not know? Do you not hear? Has it not been told you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is he who sits above the circle of the earth, for its inhabitants are like grasshoppers, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain, and spreads them like a tent to dwell in, who brings princes to nothing, and makes the rulers of the earth as emptiness. Scarcely are they planted, scarcely sown. Scarcely has their stem taken root in the earth. When he blows on them and they wither, and the tempest carries them off like stubble, to whom then will you compare them, or compare me, that I should be like him, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high and see who created these. He who brings out their host by number, calling them all by name, by the greatness of his might, and because he is strong in power, not one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint, and to him who has no might, he increases strength. Even youths shall faint and be weary, and young men shall fall exhausted. But they who wait on for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up like the wings, like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. This is the word of the Lord. The second reading is from 1 Corinthians 9, beginning on the 16th verse. If I preach the gospel, who gives me no ground for boasting? For necessity is laid upon me. Woe to me if I do not preach the gospel. For if I do this of my own will, I have a reward, but not of my own will. I am entrusted with a stewardship. What then is my reward? That is my preaching. I may present the gospel free of charge so as not to make full use of the right in the gospel. Excuse me. For though I am free from all, I have made myself a servant to all that I might win more of them. To the Jews, I become as a Jew in order to win Jews. To those under the law, I become as one under the law, though not being myself under the law, that I might win those under the law. To those outside the law, I become as one outside the law, not being outside the law of God, but under the law of Christ, that I might win those outside the law. To the weak, I become weak, that I might win the weak. I have become all things to all people, that by all means I might save some. I do it all for the sake of the gospel, that I may share with them in its blessings. Do you not know that it is race? All the runners complete, but only one receives the prize. So run that you may obtain it. Every athlete exercises self-control in all things. They do it to receive a perishable wreath, but we an imperishable. So I do not run aimlessly. I do not box as one beating the air. But I discipline my body and keep it under control, lest after preaching to others, I myself should be disqualified. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Congregation, please rise. The reading for this evening is taken from John chapter 1. The next day, Jesus decided to go to Galilee. He found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him of whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him and said of him, "Behold, an Israelite indeed, in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael said to him, "How do you know me?" Jesus answered him, "Before Philip called you, when you were under the fig tree, I saw you." Nathanael answered him, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered him, "Because I said to you, I saw you under the fig tree, do you believe? You will see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Truly I say to you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God descending and ascending and descending on the Son of Man." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
We turn now to the Apostles' Creed as we share together in our corporate faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Congregation may be seated as we sing our sermon here of the Father's love begotten.
Grace and mercy come to you all this evening from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen. Please be seated. It is good to be back here. It is good to see so many of you whom Jennifer and I knew so well. It's good to be back here because this is a very special day for you. You are going to embark on something that is sometimes difficult, this idea of an intentional interim. And Pastor Geldner is going to be able to lead you. Our verse of the day, okay, Brad, let's make sure this thing's working. There we go. Our verse of the day is this. Will you read it with me, please? Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." Come and see. That's what we're going to focus on this evening. Come and see. Now, there are two faces of Nathanael. We see them both in the lesson. We see them because, first off, we have the critical Nathanael. When he's told that Jesus is from Nazareth, he says, "Come on, can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Nazareth was not known as a great place. And Philip's words to him are, "Come and see. Come and see this Jesus that we have found." And so the other face of Nathanael then is the face that says, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God, the King of Israel." What made the change? What made the change in him that he could go from the cynical Nathanael to the confessing Nathanael? It was the face of Jesus himself. It was the words of Jesus. It was the fact that Jesus could say, "I saw you. I know who you are." What made the change was Jesus himself. And he makes the change in all of us, in all of the things that we do. It is all about Jesus and the mission of Jesus. The mission of Jesus is for us to preach the gospel to every living creature in the world, to show the love that Jesus first shows to us. That is the mission of Jesus, and it is the mission that Pastor Geldner brings to you, to show the love that he has for you that will grow, to encourage the love that you have for each other so that it grows. It all comes back to the mission of Jesus. The mission of Jesus is love. The mission of Jesus is sharing the gospel. And if you don't know it yet, you're going to hear all about his exploits, if you want to call it that, or his spending time in Africa as a missionary. You're going to hear about it. He loves to talk about it. The mission of Jesus is something that he understands very well. And he's going to try to help you to understand it too. But Nathanael had to choose, didn't he? Nathanael had to choose which one of those personas, if you want to call them that, he was going to keep going with. Remember what the two were? There was the cynical Nathanael on one side and the confessing Nathanael on the other side. But Nathanael had to choose. When Philip said those words to him, "Come and see," Philip had to make a choice. And it's not 12 chapters later that we see Philip again as the Greeks come to Jesus and they come up to him and they say, "Sir, we would see Jesus." They wanted to see Jesus. They wanted to meet him just as the disciples had, just as Nathanael had. They wanted the face of Jesus to make a difference in their lives. They wanted to meet Jesus. But Nathanael had to choose. You see, there are times in our lives where it comes down to a choice. We have to choose to act. We have to choose to be a part of something. We have to choose not to just sit back and let others do it, but to choose ourselves. And Nathaniel had to choose. And he chose something greater than himself. He chose Jesus. He chose Jesus because all of a sudden Jesus could tell him all about himself. And what does Jesus say? Don't worry about that. You're going to see greater things than that. You are going to see angels coming down to the Son of Man. You're going to see angels taking care of him. You're going to see such great things that you have no idea. Nathanael had no idea what he was up against or what his future held. But he made that confession. Rabbi, you are the Son of God. And he chose something greater than himself. Now, I'm not going to hold Pastor Geldner up to the same level as Jesus, and don't you do it either. He's here. He's here to help. He's here to share the love that he has in his heart. There are very few pastors that I know that have as big a heart as Peter does. A heart for the ministry. A heart for the Lord. And he is here to do this intentional interim with you. And you might be the cynical side of Nathanael now and say, he came from Blaine? Can anything good come out of Blaine? Can anything good come out of the Twin Cities at all? We that live in rural Minnesota are sick and tired of all the stuff that's coming out of the Twin Cities. And you can choose that cynical side and say, can anything good happen? Can anything good come out of the Twin Cities? Or you can do what Nathanael did. You can choose. You can come and see. You can come and be a part of what is beginning this night here in this church, in your church, in his church now that you have accepted him. Come and see what the Lord has in store for you, because I got to tell you, you're going to see angels. You're going to see angels ascending and descending to this place to help. You're going to see the Lord Jesus himself here day after day after day in the lives of the people and in the lives of Pastor Geldner. Come and see. Make the choice. Make the choice to be a part of something. He has been called now to be the temporary under-shepherd. I don't know if you can see very well. The shepherd is up there on the hill, but there's a couple of black sheep in that bunch, aren't there? Are there any black sheep out here? Oh, quit it, Karen. There are skeptics among you. There are skeptics out there that are choosing to say, you know, the history of this place is just too much. There's nothing we can do to fix it. It's not true. With the Lord, all things are possible. And the temporary under-shepherd that you have is going to lead you through this process. And it all comes back to the mission of Jesus. The same thing that he preached when he was in Africa, he will preach here to you. Jesus Christ and him crucified. A stumbling block to all of those people that would sit back and be that first part of Nathanael, that can anything good come out of Nazareth part. You see, the mission of God, the mission of Jesus for this place is love. The mission of Jesus is sharing the gospel with not just you, but then you taking the gospel out to your community and sharing it with others. That is the mission of Jesus for you and for this church. And he is here to help you to heal. This church has gone through a lot. It has gone through a lot. The call process has been tedious. You have called numerous men who have said, no, this is not where the Lord is asking me to serve. And they said no so that this man could be here to start something new, to start the healing to come to you. So what will you do? What will you do? What will you do? It's a great question this evening. Will you come and see? Will you come and help him to be a part of something that could be an amazing transition for this church? Or will you sit back and be the cynic and say, I don't know, I'm going to let somebody else do that? How will you choose? Will you choose the future, or will you stay rooted in the past? Thinking about how great this church used to be, how many families we had here, all the wonderful things that we had. You see, no church stays in one place. You're either moving forward or you're moving backward. How will you choose? Which face of Nathaniel will you choose? Which one of those personas will you take on? You can sit back like Bruce Springsteen and revel in the glory days, or you can invest yourself in the care of others. You know where I got that from? Who in their life has ever been to Hennepin County Medical Center? It didn't always have the best reputation for care. But they have changed because they have gone through a process where this sign is on the wall all over the place. Invest yourself in the care of others. It is the word to everybody from the janitors on up to the surgeons. Invest yourself in the care of others. Because in doing so, they could get better at what they do. It's the same charge that we give to you this evening. Invest yourself in the care of others. Look to what others need. Look to what Pastor Geldner needs. Look to what Jesus needs in this church. And invest yourself in that care. Because you can sit and locked into the past, or you can take a look at what the future could hold for this church and for you. All of you together. And have no fear. Have no fear. Because Jesus is here. He's among us this evening. He is smiling as each one of you smiles because you are making a choice. Hopefully, you're making the right one. Have no fear. Jesus is here and he's going to continue to be here. The love that he has for you is going to continue. The forgiveness that he gives you for all of your sins every day, every single one of them, is going to continue. But what will you choose? Jesus has a plan for you. I don't know where that senior pastor thing came from. Not quite sure. Jesus has a plan for you and for this church. He has a plan for all of the things that are going to happen. He has a plan for you. And Jesus asks you to trust him. Not trust him, trust him. Trust the process. Trust the under-shepherd. But only as much as the trust that he has and the love that he has for you comes from Jesus himself. You can keep driving down the road, or you can exit into your new future. Come and see. Those are the words that Philip says to Nathanael that night. And they are the words that Jesus says to you this night. Come and see. Come and see what a difference I can make here. Come and see what a change that Jesus can bring about in this church. And in your life, as the personal relationship that you have with Jesus becomes stronger and stronger, and the corporate relationships that you have among each other also become stronger. That is the prayer that we have for you this evening. The prayer that this intentional interim program has. But most important, it is the prayer that Jesus has for you. Because he wants your heart. And when he has your heart, all the rest of it falls into place. All the rest of it falls right into place. Come and see. Make the choice. Choose to be a part of the solution. And the God of peace will send His Holy Spirit to cover you all with His grace. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
congregation, please rise for the prayers of the evening. You find printed in your bulletin, and we begin. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. And we begin with, for the ministries of Trinity and Peace and Faribault Lutheran School. And also ask that we pray for Pastor Reed and the Sudanese ministry this evening as well. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
And again, Lord, as we move into 2024 and what the Lord has put before us this year, that we come together as a congregation, as a community, not just for ourselves and our churches, but for the people that don't know Jesus. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We want to pray for the health and healing of several people here. Audrey, Barb, Chuck, Diane, Diane B., Donna, Dwight, Gloria, Lee, Lorraine, Lowell, Marilyn, Mary Ann, Mertes, Nancy, Scott, Shirley, Sherry, and Verna. Lord, you be with them and the conditions they have, the, whatever they're going through. Lord, if anybody has had a loved one that they've lost to in the last few weeks, Lord, we just pray for them, for the loss of a loved one as well. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
We also have a prayer of thanksgiving for Jim and Carolyn Cross celebrating their 55th wedding anniversary on February 8th, just coming up. Lord, we just pray for Jim and Carolyn and the many years that you've given them together. Such a blessing these days and these times that we live in to celebrate 55 years together between some of the health concerns that people have. Lord, we just lift them up to you. Lord, in your mercy. Into your hands, Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, the Lord.
Amen.
Together, let us pray as our Lord Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and grant you his eternal peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The congregation may be seated now as we sing our closing hymn, Praise the Almighty.
Oh,
congregation may be seated. Is Bob Summers here? Is he here tonight? You need to come up. Yeah, you can sit down, John. Yeah, you can. If you don't mind, we'll stand by you, but that's okay. Yeah, you turn around and face the congregation. So I want to tell you, one of the first persons that I met here when I came, I snuck in on a Wednesday afternoon, and the secretary, Jenny, she was gone. She just popped out for lunch. And the first person I met was Pastor Reet. And we had met each other before up in a conference or something like that. And as Pastor John said, they're like a magnet to me. I mean, when I go to the nursing homes and stuff, I always asking them, where are you from? You know, and they get a little freaked out. And then they start talking about, we've been in Africa before. And then it's always exciting. So we're going to pray over these quilts because this guy, he's taking a trip too, aren't you? Yeah. Yeah, you're taking them. They're going to be going. When are you leaving?
I'll leave the 7th Wednesday.
Yeah, they're leaving this coming Wednesday. So they're going to go into some really nice weather. I know it's not so, it's warmer here, but it's not, you know. So let's pray. Lord, we thank you for Pastor Reet and Bob and the rest of the committee that's going, you know, too, that's going to go over there to Ethiopia. And we have these 13 quilts here, Lord. We just ask that you be with them. Give them to people that need them. Reverend Malm is going to be there too. Grace Lutheran Dodge Center. They're going to be using them as well. And so we ask that you bless us in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, that they would be used and they would be there for as they go work with a team on a mission in Kenya as well. In your name we pray, amen. Anything more I have to say, kind of?
Well, we appreciate very much the support of the community and the surrounding congregations and prayer and thought and help with the projects that we're planning to go forward with in Ethiopia with the Sunni people and the Bella. Thank you.
One other thing I want to share before we leave is that this guy will get to stand behind me. It was a kind of a rocky road to him becoming a pastor, and mine was a long circuitous route too. And we were brought together by Dr. Noreen way back in 2011, 2012. And so we've been roommates at all the conferences and Maddens and all those places. So we, pastors sometimes need somebody that they can talk to, and John's that guy for me, that I could call him anytime, any place, anywhere. And we can have a good conversation. So I appreciate him coming for you, coming for me to celebrate this day together. So with that, we'll let the executive here take us out.
Go in peace, serve the Lord.